Hail, hail, folks. Welcome to the latest edition of the Belfast Bhoy Celtic Podcast live on Hail Hail Media on Spreaker. What the fuck is happening, people? One thing I would say, first of all, to start the show off is calm the fuck down. All right? Look, I've been trying, I was all intentions of doing a phone-in podcast tonight, but my computer's fucking Fred Flintstone, so that's not going to happen. What I would say is, yes, frustrating to watch. We'll talk into all the nitty gritty of it and what's happened and so on throughout the game. Going to go through what's in the news, all my usual podcast shite. And yes, it was tough to watch. So tonight's game was the Champions League qualifier. Thursday the 12th of July, what a stinking day, notoriously it is anyway. However, I'm going to shed a colossal amount of positivity on what just fucking happened, okay? So everyone, chill your fucking cacks, relax yourselves, we're not done yet, alright? So, first bit of positivity I'm going to give you, I picked it up during the game there, was 22 years ago today, the famous Tommy Burns was appointed as Celtic manager. So that's something that we need to be grateful of, and something that happened is Tommy becoming our manager. He got a tough time of it, but That man lived and breathed Celtic. So I'm going to cut the shit now and I'm going to get into the nitty-gritty. I'd prefer if you got in touch with me through my Twitter handle, which is @TheBelfastBhoy. Or scoot into the Spreaker chat room there, where Mr. Sean Brennan is already in there. Sean, hail, hail, brother. Hope you're well over there in Philly. Let me know if the sound's okay, guys, if the sound's a wee bit ropey. I'm doing this with headphones in here, sitting in my living room. I've had a few half-litre tins of Budweiser. Few is probably underestimating the amount of Budweiser that I've had today, but oh well, it's the 12th of July and all that, you know. So, tonight we tackled the Gibraltar Minnows. Didn't turn out to be fucking minnows, however. Lincoln Red Imps. I'm even embarrassed by the fucking name of these guys. At the Victoria Stadium in Gibraltar. Yes, we got a tough time from the Hard Knocks, from the Rock. And 960 Celtic fans attended that game tonight. Funny wee fucking place in general Gibraltar is, but that stadium was fucking odd. It was an eerie place, fucking planes and shit taking off in the background. But it wasn't for good viewing, like, let's be honest. Okay, I'm not gonna try and sugarcoat that part of it. It was bad. But what I would say to you is we're a work in progress. We've had 4 preseason games and this is our preseason, really. And yes, I am fully aware that our hard games come before the league starts. Okay, that's down to the coefficient, that's down to us being chained to fucking maniacs. Teams like Aberdeen and fucking Hibs next year will be in Europe. And let's be honest, they're hardly going to fucking whack any group stages of any competition. So let's be honest. I know the people are kicking Effie and kicking Scott Brown and looking some fucker to blame. And just woosah, chill the fuck out. I know it's frustrating as fuck to watch. But the team news doesn't really say much. We're still Ronnie Dyla-esque in our formation, and Rodgers seems to be, he's in a transition period here where he doesn't want to make the same mistake that Dyla made, where Ronnie cut a lot of fat very, very quickly, okay, and we suffered as a consequence of it. Like, let's be honest, we haven't qualified for the Champions League in a long, long time. So Rodgers doesn't want to make the same mistake that Ronnie Dale has made, okay? So what I would say is that you can't trim too much fat too soon and leave yourself exposed in general. So tonight, as far as new signings go, there was Dembele. Ambrose in the team, I think we're going to see movement on signing people over the next week or so, but we may only make signings based on do we progress in the Champions League, because let's be honest, no one wants to come to a team that normally all we have to shout about is, do you want to play Champions League football? Yeah, do you want to play Champions League football? Right, we'll come to Celtic. If we lose that, then we don't have very much to shout about, okay? What I think is that the team tonight lacked in the final third. The final third was it, and in reality, all we were playing with up front was Dembele, and Griffiths was playing sort of in the number 10 role there behind him, so we did try and freshen it up in the second half after they scored, with Forrest coming on and Armstrong coming on. It didn't work, but it's not the be-all and end-all. What matters is that when we go into our next game, yes, I know that our next game is against Wolfsburg on Saturday at Celtic Park, but even more so, when these fucking red imps, whatever the fuck they're called, come to Parkhead, that it's a packed Parkhead, and we put the fear of God in those little Gibraltar bastards. It's embarrassing, the quote that, so going into the, what their players do for a living is embarrassing. So we're, I've written this down somewhere here, what the fuck. Two policemen, one customs officer, and one shipping agent.
Oh, Willie Millie was his name. He brought some great names to the game when he was the boss at Celtic Park. He taught them how to play football. He made the greatest of them all.
Johnson Tully. Yo, Chuck, what's the move, man? I was on my way up here to the studio, you know what I'm saying? And this brother stopped me and asked me, yo, what's up with that brother Chucky D? He swear he nice. I said, yo, the brother don't swear he nice. He knows he's nice, you know what I'm saying? So, Chuck, I got a feeling you turning into a public enemy, man. Now, remember that line you was kicking to me on the way out to L.A. Lounge in Queens while we was in the car on our way to the shop? Well, yo, right now, kick the bass for them brothers and let them know
what goes on. Rolling Stones in the rap game, not bragging. Look bigger than Jagger, not sagging. His brother backwards, I'ma leave it at that. That ain't got nothing to do with rap. Shot the bats, expose those cats. Who pose as heroes, take advantage of blacks. Your government's gangsters, so cut the crap. A war going on, so where y'all at? Fight for power, cause great responsibility. F the police, people, who's stopping you from killing me? Disastrous fiascos on loop by P.E. If it's I instead of we believe in TV. Spreading rich and bitches, this new thing about snitches. Watch the masses move as the masses switches. System distant, but barely missed her. My sole intention to save my brothers and sisters. Get up!
This like that.
So 20 years later, of course it does, while consciousness faded. New generations believe in them fables. Gangsta boogie on two turntables. So no love, so it's easy to hate it. Desecrated while the coroner waited. Any given Sunday, so where y'all reigning? With slavery lynching and them drugs infiltrated. I'm like that doll Chucky, baby. Keep coming back to live love life like I'm crazy. Keep it moving, rising to the top. Duck fresh, clean living, you don't stop. Revolution means change, don't look at me strange. So I can't repeat what other rappers be saying. If you don't stand for something, you fall for anything. Harder than you think is a beautiful thing. Get up! It's time to leave you a preview, so you two can review what we do. 20 years in this business, how you sell soul, she wins. People bear witness. Thank you for letting us be ourselves. So don't mind me if I repeat myself. These simple rhymes be good for your health, to keep them crime rhymes on the shelf. Live, love life like you just don't care. 5,000 leaders never scared. Rain the noise is the moment they feared. Get up, still a beautiful idea. Get up, throw your hands in the air. And show no fear. Get up if y'all really care. Need 20 years. Now get up.
Yeah, that's right. We're public enemy number one in New York. Public enemy number one in Philly. Public enemy number one in D.C. Public enemy number one in Cleveland, Ohio. Oh, so we're public enemy number one in St. Louis. Public enemy number one in New Jersey. And fuck it. We're also public enemy number one.